Good morning, everybody. This time I'm going to present to you some material on past continuous and when and why. Here we have what are we going to do today is to know how do we use at the past continuous tense. Let's start first with a concept of past continuous. Again, here I have put something in Spanish, so it will clarify the topic that we're going to talk about. And el pasado continuo se utiliza para oraciones que ocurren en un momento específico en el pasado. Se forma con el verbo auxiliar to be y el gerundio. El verbo auxiliar to be debe estar en pasado simple. Here we have the basic structure of the past continuous. First we have the subject. The subject can be I, he, she, it, or you, we, and they. The auxiliary, we have a different auxiliary for each person. In here we have I, he, she, it, and that is with was. And then we have you, we, they, and that is with were. And here we have some examples of the gerund. Remember, my friends, please remember they always have to be together. The past continuous, the auxiliary to be, and the gerund together always. Here we have some examples, and it says talking, so it has to be he was talking, she was doing, they were doing. Together, always the auxiliary and the gerund. What do we have in here as the structure for each kind of sentence or statement in this past continuous? First, we have for affirmative, and for affirmative, the structure is subject, the auxiliary verb, which I just mentioned, it is the to be verb, which is was aware. The ing verb, please, always, together, and the complement, if it is necessary. Sometimes, like in here, I was talking, or he was eating, it is not necessary, but they were learning Spanish, well, we just put it in here, but it could be only they were sleeping without complement, and the phrase or the sentence is perfectly understood. Negative sentences. For negative sentences, we have similar structure, subject, verb. And what is additional in here is the negative word not, and it makes the auxiliary verb negative, and it could be wasn't or weren't, plus the ing verb always together again, plus a complement. So these auxiliary verb and the negative word can be in full, like in here, or in contrast. I was not or I wasn't talking, he was not or he wasn't eating. And in negative, we can use question words or just was aware. These are called informative questions, and these are called yes no questions. So if we use question words, we have to put it before the auxiliary, and then again, my friends, again the auxiliary to be and the ing verb. In here the order change, first is the verb and then the subject, because it's a question, but it is going to be an ing verb together, always the auxiliary and the ing. Here we have some examples. Were you talking? Was he eating? Was Jim doing his homework? Verb, subject, auxiliary. Verb, subject, auxiliary. What do we have in here as the different uses of past continuous? First, it says we use this in different actions that happen in certain time in the past. And here it says, for example, he was walking in the garden at 7 o'clock this morning. Walking in the garden, walking was working, okay? It is a long action, okay? It takes some time. That is why it is in progress. I was watching TV, Miguel was cooking. Another situation where we use the past continuous is to talk about a specific time in the past. For example, in here it says, Paula wasn't living in Spain in 2005. This is the specific time in 2005. And it says that Paola no estaba viviendo en España en el 2005, a specific time. Then we have another use, and it is to describe or talk about sentence stories. Sorry, stories that are written in past. Okay? Here we have a story relating something that happened yesterday or the day before. And it says, the sun was shining and the birds were singing and the elephant came out of the jungle. The other animals were relaxing. All this situation is in past. Okay? They are relating or narrating a story in past. Now, what do we have in here is another use of simple past, and this time it's going to introduce the use of why and when. And it says, la acción que está en pasado continuo es con while, y la acción que provoca la interrupción está en pasado simple y se utiliza con when. When y while señalan el uso del pasado simple y del pasado continuo. Aquí tenemos ejemplos y dice José called while I was watching the news. Called es la acción corta, es la acción que está interrumpiendo la acción larga que yo estaba haciendo acá. ¿Cuál es? Was watching TV. ¿Y qué pasó? El teléfono sonó. ¿Por qué? Porque José llamó. ¿Ya? Aquí tenemos con when. He was walking to work when he fell. ¿Cuál es la acción larga? Was walking, porque toma un tiempo. ¿Y cuál es la acción corta? Fell. Caer. Te caes, no te estás cayendo, sino te caes. Pero sí estás caminando. Por eso was walking es una acción larga y fell es una acción corta. Tenemos aquí que dice se utiliza cuando dos acciones están ocurriendo al mismo tiempo en el pasado. Have a look the picture, please. And here we have, it says, two actions happening at the same time. Here is the example, this is my daughter. This is my daughter. What is my daughter doing? What was doing? Sleeping. My daughter was sleeping while I was cooking. Two actions happening at the same time. This is my daughter, this is me. Sleeping and cooking at the same time. Here we have another example with while with two long actions. Okay? It's saying in here, and it says while is used when there are two long actions happening at the same time. Here we have, it says, John was drawing a picture while he was smiling. This is John, this is another person, and these two people are doing actions at the same time. John was drawing and he is smiling. He was, sorry, is two actions happening at the same time or happened at the same time in the past. And here we have a use with when. Remember, when is used to interrupt a long action. So when is talk about the short action. For example, in here we have Mr. Lee. Mr. Lee was using the computer and the computer went off, stopped working, broke down. Okay, so Mr. Lee was using the computer when the computer broke down. The computer stopped working. in a flash. Okay. Here we have another use of when, and it says use is when with periods of life in the past. Here it is an example, and when I was 12. Here we have an example with an expression, and it says, when I was a little boy, power cats were very frequent. This is a period of time in past. My friends, this is the information for today. I hope it will help you in some way. And bye for now.